Can you just explain to me what the Oral-B iO10 with iOSense is? What's it sort of all about?
Yeah, so I would say it is almost putting a dentist professional in your bathroom each time you brush your teeth. And that's really what it is about. And to do that, actually, we put all our, let's say, knowledge on the technology. So it is certainly the best brushing ever for, let's say, in the industry. But it is also, let's say, a tech product. So we really put AI at the service of the outcome. And when I say, it is like putting a dentist professional at home, actually, we've been learning from thousands of brushing patterns to help actually each individual buying iO10 to really guide them on, let's say, when, where, and how to brush. And actually, with iO10 and the iOSense, on the when, you have really, let's say, a timer, but very visible one to help you, guiding you to optimize your brushing, but also guiding you, on the different, let's say, location of your mouth. On the where, you have also, let's say, intuitive lights on the device, so the additional device coming with iO10 to help you, guiding you, on the right location. And on the how, actually, we still have, the iO app that we keep on improving. And this is really where we put a lot of AI, artificial intelligence. Of the brushing patterns we've been accumulating together with the dentist professional. That's really a co-design with them. So actually, the guiding principles are really based on how to best brush your teeth if you were actually yourself a dentist professional. So on the app, you're going to have a direct feedback. And it is really a rewarding and enjoyable experience because it's quite, dynamic. But you have almost a scoring in the end. So you see the smile, on the handle, but actually you have a lot of details on the app on whether you were good on the pressure, on whether you were good on mapping actually the key area of your mouth. And of course, it makes a huge difference in the end on the results. So that's really what iO10 is all about. And again, to be maybe more specific, iO10 is really coming with this iOSense, which is the additional device, because we also recognized by listening our consumers that actually the handle with the information in were good, the app was good, but you don't want to come each time in your bathroom with your mobile phone. And they are really asking for an additional device always in your bathroom, guiding you and coming up with clear indications to improve, the experience. And it is what iO10 is all about.
Okay, so the iOSense is a separate device that you keep in your bathroom and it shows you how you're brushing live at the time.
You've got it.
Perfect. Okay. So this is another level of personalized oral healthcare. You have previously had the app, but this takes it to another level. What kind of role do you feel that technology has in helping to improve the oral health of our patients?
Yeah, so I will be back to the technology in a minute, but first of all, I think for us, it's all about shifting people to power, where we believe we have a very proven technology with very tangible results. So when you move from manual to power toothbrush, actually, you remove 100% more plaque. And we know removing plaque has an immediate impact on your health. So it's a big deal. And the penetration on power is still relatively low. If you take, the average of Europe, it's 29%. Probably in the UK, a little bit more, okay? Certainly more, probably between 30% to 35%. But if you take some the best-in-class countries, we are at 60% in the Netherlands. We are at 45% plus in Germany, and even more close from 50% in some of the Nordics countries. So we still have a lot of opportunities, even for the UK, to have a majority of people using power. Now, we have the right technology. We co-design with dentists. We put a lot of technology to shift and to move the experience to the next level. And we believe we need to guide people as well, let's say, brushing let's say, in a better way. And the AI technology is making a huge difference because actually we benchmark each and every individual versus the number one. And the number one is the dentist professional. It's like tennis, you know, you're going to be benchmarked against Nadal, against the best in class, you know, player. And then it's going to tell you, okay, what are the improvement areas? And the idea actually is not only you have the best brushing experience because of power, but actually on the journey to improve, you know, your capabilities, you're going to become actually a very great, you know, users of your product. And it's going to be done in a very rewarding and enjoyable, let's say, experience, because again, it is very dynamic. You have several tools on the handles with already a lot of informations. And let's say the device for IO10, which will stay in your bathroom, and on top with the app, which actually gives you a lot of, let's say, feedback and guiding principles to improve the experience. And we continue, it's a continuous, you know, improvement of the platform. When I was telling you, we have thousands of patterns of brushing. Of course, we keep accumulating, you know, the brushing experiences, and we keep on improving and investing into the app, so that it is in continuous improvements. And of course, because we have regular refresh of the app, all the IO users benefit from the improvement of the app, let's say on a regular basis. And we keep on investing with our researchers and developers to make sure it keeps on improving. So it's a very dynamic platform.
So the IO Sense isn't to take over from the app. The app will still run alongside the IO Sense.
Yeah, it comes on top. And what you're going to have on the IO Sense is not at the level of granularity of right. What you're going to get from the app. It is just coming up from, let's say, observing and listening to consumers, which love the app. And it's not, by the way, because you don't look at your mobile or you don't open your mobile during your brushing, that it does not record your experience. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you just want to leave aside, you know, your mobile phone. So still your brushing will be recorded, but you want to interact directly, you know, in simple manners in your bathroom with tools that will stay there. And the IO device, let's say with IO 10, the new device, the IO Sense, will stay always in your bathroom, will be always there, and will give you simple, you know, let's say, guiding principles, which will help you. And again, that's state of the art, of course, the best product, but really, let's say, delivering on all consumers' expectations, literally.
Okay, perfect. So you mentioned that there is still a large percentage of people who don't use a power brush. What do you think are the big barriers? What are the big sticking points for them to make that transition, and how do you hope to overcome those?
I think they need to understand why, what is the benefit to move there. And actually, that's also the job we do with our dentist professionals, because the best one, you know, to advise to shift from manual to power are the dentist professionals.
Yeah.
So maybe let me start with that. We are number one recommended brand with dentist professionals, precisely because it's a very proven technology. And of course, they need to be convinced by the technology. They need also to understand that it is also for them. And we know that on gum sensitivity, sometimes, you know, people are not fully clear on the impact of power. Is it really okay for my gum, okay for the sensitivity? Actually, yes, big yes. And on IO, actually, we made further progress on gums protection and gum sensitivity. And last but not least, we want also to move from, let's say, a very, let's say, cold mind decision to also a very emotional decision. And if you look at IO, hopefully you see a very beautiful product and an object of desire, I want to say. And with IO10, actually, we are pushing with even, let's say, new, let's say, colors, very, very premium aspects. And as it is for some industries, let's say the smartphone is a good one. You don't have only your smartphone because of the, let's say, all the capabilities of the tool. You have it because it's also a beautiful object, and it's part of the social life almost. That's what we are talking with IO now. It is really an object of desire, and we have a lot of people jumping into that, precisely for the because of the iconic design. And one interesting number for I/O, because I/O is quite an expensive product. It's quite premium. We have 30% of the people who are coming directly from manual to I/O. So think about it. On manual, you are spending few pennies, a couple of pennies if you want, and then you are jumping straight to a quite expensive tool, 30%. It's even more, I think, in the UK. I think it's even probably 35%. So it's even above Europe average. So a lot of people are coming straight, let's say, from the basics to the most advanced tool, also because of this very iconic design. So that's also an important pillar here, and we worked a lot on the design to make it extremely attractive.
Okay, so people are ready to make that jump. But for those where price is a barrier, you do have the I/O 4 and I/O 5 as kind of an introductory level. Do those brushes miss out on anything that maybe the I/O 10 has? What's the difference between the introductory level and the I/O 10?
Trying to simplify to the extreme, the engine is the same. But you don't have the options.
Right.
See what I mean? So what do I mean by options? The I/O Sense will not be available, of course. The magnetic charger, so beautiful magnetic charger, will not be available. The number of modes will be different. So you have a couple of differences, if you want, moving from, let's say, a more affordable product to really democratize the I/O technology. That's really the role of 4 and 5. To really, let's say, an I/O 10, where actually you want the full options. Yeah. And so, again, we know that some consumers are really after the full option, proposition.
Yeah, okay. Okay, so with this latest update, the Oral-B is certainly maintaining its position as a leading force in helping with patients' oral health regime at home. What do you feel are the next steps? Where does Oral-B go from here?
I mean, first of all, we are not only a power oral care player, and actually in the UK, we have all our lineup listed. When I say lineup, I mean all the product proposition, and it starts, with power, but it continues with premium paste product, also floss, also mouthwash. And actually, the intent for us is to be simply the best generalist oral care player in any market. And UK is a good example. And we want to make sure we improve the oral health of our people. Education, accessibility of our products. And education, because we know from, clinical studies that a good oral care health journey has a direct impact on your health. And I'm not sure it is a great pleasure for anyone to go at the dentist for a long period of time because you have, issues. We know that using on a regular basis, power oral care with the right products will reduce massively, the risk on some specific, disease. It will reduce, some risk on some specific disease. It will improve the gum health. It's very proven. So we have a lot of data on all of this. And ideally, we want to have a majority of people using power, people using as well the right, toothpaste products, combined with floss, combined with mouthwash. And of course, today you have a lot of, consumers just using a basic manual, a basic paste. Mm-hmm. So that's really our mission. And it starts from the kids to the very senior people. So we are really touching the entire, span of the consumers. And we have huge program for kids. I have kids personally. And actually starting with power when you are kids and we have specific products for them, it makes a huge difference. And if we change, the habits of the people, we will certainly improve the oral health in any country. And it will be very meaningful on the health of our people. So that's a bit of the superior missions we are after. And we do that always with dentists at the center. So we have very, very strong partnership with them and all the products are co-developed, co-designed with them.
Right, okay. And touching on artificial intelligence, that's a really exciting area of healthcare. Where do you see that falling into the oral health regime in the future?
So, actually, first of all, you know, we are at NWC this year, not by chance, because we are really a tech company. And we are also keep on working to improve our platform. I think, and of course, all of this is done, you know, with the, let's say, old GDPR context in mind. So on data, we are extremely strict as well. Now, of course, all of this will keep on evolving. And we are investing a lot every year. And as I was telling you, the engine of IO will stay the same. But actually, the platform, the app, and the artificial intelligence will benefit from all the latest developments. And on this, I can tell you, we progress every quarter because we keep on investing a lot with our research and development teams and developers to keep on improving the platform. So I cannot, you know, paint really what will be the future, but I can tell you that we're going to guide people, let's say, more and more. We're going to do that in a more and more enjoyable experience. And at the moment, it covers, you know, guiding them on their brushing. But of course, we can think about, let's say, additional steps to cover even more from, you know, analyzing, you know, the starting point for them so that we come up with the right, you know, indicated action on brushing, but also on the right products to use. An area of opportunities to keep on delivering, let's say, the best, oral care experience at home, inspired by dentists themselves. So that's a bit the direction, and AI will help us a lot, and technology will help us a lot. What we want to allow, and IoT is a great example, is keep it simple for our people. Because we know it is not by over-complexifying, you know, the experience that it will be so enjoyable. So that's always the tensions we are putting to ourselves. Simplicity, enjoyable experience, but certainly on technology, we are just at the very beginning.
Certainly, I think simplicity is key, particularly those moving from a manual to an electric toothbrush. It's such a jump. Simplicity is absolutely key. One other area that is quite key at the moment is the environment. So what is Oral-B doing to ensure it has a positive impact on the environment?
Yeah, so on this one, first of all, on good for the planet, we work on all the different aspects, if you want. So it starts from manufacturing our product right. And we are zero waste to landfill. We are recyclable, let's say, energies in all our sites, and we produce in Europe. So clearly, you know, it's a critical one for us. And we are reducing as well on the, let's say, greenhouse gases, you know. We are over-delivering on our targets big time to reduce, let's say, the footprint. So maybe, Paola, you can help me here, but I think we have reduced by 35%, you know, our, let's say, greenhouse gas, while actually the target was 30% reduction by 2030. So we have really a strong plan just to manufacture the product right, okay? Then we want to make sure we act on packaging as well, coming up with the right recyclable packaging, and that's something we do. On IO, it's clearly the case. And then we are also working, because we are electronic products, on repairability. And on repairability, we are already a test in motion in Germany. We have repairability possible for our premium products on power, and that's something which will be coming as well, you know, in the rest of Europe. So we are working, let's say, on good for the planet pillar a lot, and we have a clear, a strong agenda to be really, you know, best in class here. And then we have also all the work done on education and accessibility to make sure, and it was particularly true with COVID, we help, let's say, with NGOs and Red Cross in particular during the COVID time to have our product available, to make sure we do the right education with kids. And for us, we are also in a mission here because, again, it's not only being an object of desire. They need to understand as well in very practical, you know, terms, what it means, you know, using the right product, using power oral care, using the right, you know, paste, let's say, toothpaste product, floss, et cetera, to really improve their health, and what could be the damage on increasing the risk of stroke, increasing even the risk, let's say, during pregnancy for women. All of this, we have clinical studies, and again, we spend a lot of money and energy to, let's say, understand with the right researchers, dentist professionals, the risk, let's say, the best way to educate people. And it's really a partnership with all our partners, starting with dentist professionals. So that's a bit the sustainability plan, if you want.
Yeah, okay. Perfect. Benjamin, thank you so much for explaining all of that. It certainly sounds like an exciting time ahead for Oral-B. And yeah, thank you for taking the time to speak to me all about it.